All right, this is Psycho Seamstress with Rock Rage Radio, and we are kicking it with Kickin Valentina at the Haven in Winter Park, Florida.
What's up?
Julie,
what's up?
How you guys doing?
Hey, what's up? How you doing?
So, you guys, I was reading, I know you won the Band of the Year, Band of the Year, Georgia Music Awards.
Mm-hmm.
So what you guys been doing?
We just finished working on a new album, which comes out on the 28th. So this month, we can't wait to have it. We don't even have it in our hands yet, so we're getting antsy. Finishing the video for the single, Wrong Way, and we just started to work to promote it. So
cool.
Yeah.
Get me a copy. We'll play it on the radio station for you.
Cool.
Yeah. Cool. So I'm a wardrobe seamstress, as you know. I do like wardrobe stuff. So I have a kind of a crazy question for you. If you could steal anybody's costume, whether it's a character or a person in the movies or whatever, and wear it on stage, who would you be?
Well, that could be a loaded question.
Yeah, I know, I know.
Birthday suit.
Yeah?
Play with my third stick.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. I'm down. Get sick now.
Are you going to top that?
He can't.
Spread the guitar a little bit low, you know?
Yeah. I play it low. But,
there you go.
But, wow. Who would I don't even know. That's
Darth Vader.
Yeah, or something.
Like,
yeah. Star Wars.
Like,
Star Wars. We love Star Wars. So I guess anybody from Star Wars.
Yeah.
I thought he was going to say Princess Leia, but, you know.
Well,
you got Jabba the
Hutt. The metal bikini.
Yeah. I mean, I love that, right?
Yeah, yeah. Cool. Mm-hmm. So, if there was a piece of clothing that you had in your wardrobe at one point that you lost somewhere along the line or got stolen or whatever, anything you could get back from the 80s or something crazy?
Oh, yeah, all my lip service shit.
Yeah, yeah.
All my lip service stretch pants.
Yeah.
Not
so much that we probably wear it now, but I mean, it's just, a lot of that
nostalgic
stuff.
Nostalgic.
The old
Vision streetwear.
Yeah. Garters and stockings and all that stuff. We back in the
glam
days.
Yeah.
Oh, my 6-inch stiletto heels. I mean, I miss those.
Yeah. The Gene Simmons boots. Yeah.
Right. Awesome.
It's hard to play a drum set in heels.
Right. Yeah. What are you like? Usually, they won't even wear a shirt.
You don't want to see me naked. A lot of alcohol, maybe, but not sober.
Not so much.
It's not pretty.
Cool. If, have you guys had any good wardrobe malfunctions you can tell me about?
Yeah.
Blowing your pants open?
Our singer just did it in the parking lot. He had to change.
Seriously.
Can you tell me what happened?
He blew the ass out of his pants.
Yeah. Luckily, it happened out in the parking lot and not on stage.
We're getting on.
Chris had a groin malfunction on one of his pair of pants, didn't he? One time?
Yeah,
one of the shows, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
Shit, I got to change my pants.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, nothing so far that's been, much something happened tonight, right?
No.
I mean, look at straight on around and go, God damn it. Yeah.
Well, I'll be right there with my camera, right?
Make sure you're going to need Zoom.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Oh, good Lord. Listen to that.
Mm-hmm. As you can tell, we fuck with each other all the time.
Right.
I can say that on a...
You guys have been on quite a tour for a while, or what's your schedule
really
been like?
We don't do like full
festivals.
Tours, but I mean, as of since we won the award, we did like a festival in Denver, we did a festival in Pekin, Illinois, we did a festival out in Maryland.
Did you do Soundwave?
We did Soundwave.
Yeah, my friend Kim was Volvatron, and that was like when they announced her.
Yeah.
That was like her coming out party.
Yeah, and that was a fun festival because we played with Trickster. And
LA
Guns and Kicks. Which is really cool because, we're playing with all the bands that we grew up
So what other dates do you guys have in Florida? I saw you got a...
This is the last one in Florida. We were Fort Lauderdale yesterday and Miami the day before.
Where'd you play? Culture Room?
Ridiculous. In Miami.
Yeah.
Grand Central.
Okay.
Yeah. It's for the Monsters of Rock pre-party.
Okay, gotcha. Right.
So that, and then tonight here, and then we're off to back to Atlanta to do a show on Sunday. Yeah.
So I ran into your friends, Pretty Maids, on 70,000 Tons last year,
Kenny and Alana, great.
Yeah, those guys
Renee,
were great.
They're all
I just happened
Morgan.
To be in the band gear room, and they were coming in to get their stuff to get ready for their show, and I was like, wait, I got a message for you.
Yeah.
Jerry Verdine says to say hi.
Yeah.
Cool.
Probably so, like who?
Yeah. No, they knew who you were.
Okay.
Yeah. Have you guys ever thought about playing a cruise like that? Or
trust me when I say that we are, with every waking moment of our breath, we are trying to get on all of them.
Oh, all right.
Because it's, you know, what's great about those cruises, you have 5,000 people stuck there,
yeah.
And those are the hardcore.
Yes.
Like, because it's rock, metal, the
right.
whole freaking day for
yeah.
4 days. You know, they're going to see you. And
right.
if they dig you,
yeah.
you're good. You're golden.
What's
you know?
Cool about it is you play more than once. You know, you play on one stage one day and another
yep.
stage mm-hmm. another day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you do the meet and greets. You have dinner with people. It's cool because if you've got some, you know, a good following.
It's very laid
it's
back.
It's nice. Yeah. A lot of the bands, I think Apocalyptica did like a listening party for their record release and stuff like that. So that's cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, we like to hang out with our fans and stuff like that. Miami was amazing. We met so many cool people
yeah.
that were going on the cruise.
Uh-huh.
We all were like pulling out of Miami. You know, this morning going, fuck.
I wish
only
I could go.
On the boat.
Right?
We're on the damn boat.
Yeah, well, so. You're halfway. Does the promoter book all that pre-show stuff?
There's different promoters throughout.
Yeah.
They do different
yeah.
things. Yeah. Because
I know on 70,000 Tons, they have some stuff that's organized. And all the bands kind of are in that area anyway, so you may as well pick up a gig.
Oh, this
you know,
whole weekend
there.
In Florida, there's been shows all over the place.
Yeah, yeah. exactly. Mm-hmm.
The show we did in Miami, the pre-party thing, was 13 bands. Nothing that's on the cruise.
Right.
But there were some, you know, Jakey Lee played, Steve Summers from Pretty Boy Floyd played.
Right.
The old school band from L.A. London.
Yeah.
That played. Some other various artists that have played with, like Wasp and other bands. And stuff
right.
like that bands and they played. So it was cool, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of nice people, made a lot of new fans. You know, it's cool.
Cool.
I'm getting texts on Facebook from people saying, oh, we're seeing Kickin' Valentina shirts all over the cruise ship.
Cool.
Which is
oh,
really good.
Awesome.
Yeah. So,
yeah. Picked up some merch.
Yeah. Yeah. We've actually, yeah, we were just talking about that coming up here, too. We're like, man, for an up-and-coming band, we sell a shitload of merchandise.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing.
Well, I think, and maybe you can give me your take on this, the dynamic, I think, has changed with music over the last, you know, from the 80s and 90s. Because, you know, people don't buy CDs anymore, really. They might download a song or two. It's just the dynamic has changed. Things are downloaded instead of purchased. Do you feel like, you know, do you feel pressure to tour and do a lot of merchandise to...
I think every band does.
That's how the
business has become. So
they have to
do that to feed their families. That's,
right.
that's the reality.
Exactly.
So you,
yeah.
It used to be about playing music and selling albums. Now
right.
Now you became a, you know...
touring rock star.
No, well, not now. We've changed into being, you know, you're selling T-shirts, you know.
Yeah.
That's
your
that's
merch.
The,
yeah.
The, you know, so it's but you know, you still want to obviously be out there and play.
I think for the fans and people like me who do wardrobe and people, you know, who work concert production, event production. I know I've been doing event concert production for 30 years, and I've seen an increase in the amount of rock shows because of these festival tours and
bands
are just out touring
it's
now.
I think it's starting to become a little bit more.
United States is finally
catching up.
Yeah,
to Europe.
That's true.
Again,
yeah,
you know,
we're getting some really good festivals over here.
And
now.
We're involved actually with Freddie Stalmer, Farm Rock,
uh-huh.
Desert Rock Series. We're actually doing a show in November in Atlanta, a Farm Rock style indoor festival in Atlanta. And we're also playing Farm Rock in Wakanda, Illinois, with like Slaughter Kicks, Quiet Riot,
right,
all 80s. And then
we're doing Rockfest.
Rockfest in Wisconsin,
Wisconsin
is big
Wisconsin
one. Just with Shine Down
with
Priest, Nickelback,
Rock,
and Bush, and Jackal, and Adelita's Way. And it's all modern and, you know,
I'm
old school
be
and modern. Yes.
Going to Fort Rock next week, and then Rockville next week, and then the radio station we're covering, Carolina Rebellion. Rock on the Range.
All
the
AEG events.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
a big
yeah.
one. That's what we're trying to get in with.
Okay. Well,
you can land a gig with AEG.
You
you're,
yeah.
You're good.
I know some people.
Do you?
Yeah.
We'll have to talk.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Well, thanks, guys.
Right,
good
no,
luck
you.
With your show.
Thank you.
Looking
glad
forward to seeing
out.
You.
Oh,
and
cool. Just rock and roll.
Say if you could give me a little PR for Psycho Seamstress on Rock Rage Radio.
Psycho Seamstress Rock Rage Radio. Check her out. Go buy a bunch of stuff from her. Show her some love. This is Jimmy Berdine, drummer, kicking back.